Hello, my name is Oksana Pichugina. I am presenting you a talk, Attributed Networks Formation Models with Application in Social Network Analysis. Network analysis is a research area studied intensively lately. Researchers investigate structural characteristics of different networks, networks formation models, and many other related questions. Among various networks, social ones, which reflect the diversity of people relationship are a priority. In many types of networks, and in social networks particularly, exist observable and tightly bound groups of elements called communities. How and why communities arise is an interesting and important question. It is also important to analyze possible ways of community detection. In this paper, networks characterized by nodes with several attributes, attributed networks are studied. The networks cover a wide class of real-world networks, particularly social networks, making them especially attractive for further development. Other related questions with attributed networks are the reconstruction of missing nodes and ages attributes, interpretation of multi-layer community detection, which is conducted on the networks, and interpretation of the results. And finally, the main focus of our work is attributed networks formation models. Social networks is a graph represented in the form of one, where V is a set of nodes, E is a set of ages, lambda and lambda prime are matrices which represent information about attributes related to nodes and ages respectively. There are specific properties of social networks that researcher try to reproduce, but there is no such models yet that represent all the properties. First of all, this is heterogeneity of nodes and ages. Next one is sparsis, which is means that low density coefficient. Next one is the height average clustering coefficient, meaning that there are communities in the networks, and small average shortest path lengths, ASPL, which is one of effect of small world, and power law degree distribution. There are some notation where K prime is the number of nodes and ages or attributes. Values of all attributes form matrices. And within this annotation, there is a classification of all attributed networks into two classes, where unattributed, not attributed, age attributed, and not and age attributed. The last one represent social networks particularly. There are in this slide you can see main formulas that that allows us to check if our network is social. Does it have the properties listed above? And we will form mathematical model and respectively use mathematical concept in our mathematical modeling. In particular, G will represent a network, and GW is a weighted network. Corresponding to a network G and a graph G. AW is a weighted adjacency matrices, and K, index K, will represent a particular the same, but for particular attribute. So we assume that our network has our network nodes has k attributes, and respectively we will accumulate in our final networks all the subnetworks related to the attributes. And we will use a linear combination of networks, and which is represented via adjacency matrix and their linear combination. Important remark that we will operate only with normalized networks which weights are equal to one. There are two types of partition we will use. One of them is a partition of our networks into communities, and this is a result of applying community detection algorithms. And another one is attributed attribute clusters, which is partition related to each of each particular attribute k. For instance, let's assume we consider a social network where attributes are related to families and friendship. So this will be partitioned into group of families, and another one will be partitioned into groups of friends. Regarding mathematical models of attributed networks, we will use the following information and assumption that if there is no connection between two nodes, if nothing in common related to their attributes. So if no attributes in common, so no there are no in from the same family, from the same groups of friends, etc. that we consider, then no connection between these two peoples. And if they has some attributes in common, then the connection can exist or not. For instance, if two people likes the same music, but they have something in common, they have no real contact and connection. Okay, and three models of attributed networks we present. One of them is uses assumptions, and if at least one attributes is the same, then two people has the same attribute, then there is connection, real connection between them. So H is formed even if one something they have in common. And as a result, for instance, we have the three attributes. This is family, friendship, and music. As a result, we have a partition of our network into full graphs related to each of the attributes, and then we combine this all and get a new network. It will be weighted because we will assign weight to each of these networks forming a weighted network sum, and also different weight will be in with the of the ages because number of connection are different. And two more models. One of them is based on either Erdos-Renyi random graphs, and second one Barabasi-Albert preferential attachment graphs. First model model situation when some group of peoples is formed at the at one moment, and the people does not know who is more popular, who is not, who is more interesting person in the group, and that is why their contacts are formed randomly. In Barabasi-Albert graphs, it is modeled situation where people, the group is formed consecutively, and people has additional information about popularity of one person and or another. That is why it is formed in different way. And let's assume that we will model in iGraph, which is implemented in R, a network with 60 nodes and three attributes. And there is a network corresponding to Erdos-Renyi random graphs and the resulting network, similar to previous one, but this is a little different. And this the third one is preferential attachment model. You can see how the groups are formed, and because of the preferential attachment, we have as a result such accumulated network. And three next slides demonstrates statistics related to degree distribution in each of the network. In each of the network, degree distribution is degenerated in one point, but in the aggregation network, we have such distribution. It is clear that this is not power law one. The same corresponds to second network, but for preferential attachment model, we see that indeed it is closely these points corresponding to the degrees closely lies within on near the line, and also we can here also approximate the line by power function, so here approximation is good. And next three slides shows us how is it possible in the resulting network to detect communities, because if it is not, our model is bad. We see that in original subnetworks corresponding to each of the component of or to each of the attributes, it is clear how the communities are formed. But in the final networks and in the final work, it is not so clear. And to understand equality, we use a modularity coefficient. It is as close it to one as better our network. And you see that here modularity is near one, but here is about 40% only, so not a good. And next one is Barabasi-Albert random graphs. The same here, it's clear how the communities are detected, because the networks are a set of isolated graphs. But here we can also detect communities, but modularity is about 40% as well. And finally, is a preferential attachment model. You see a similar detection. Number of communities is more than in previous case, but here you see that modularity is more than 60%, which is better than previous two. And this slide shows for our first two models characteristics of social networks properties corresponding to each of subgraphs in the final networks, and the same here for the third one. And to summarize, some summaries in the last table where zero correspond to worst situation, worst case for in each worst rank, one is the best rank, and 0.5 is in the intermediate, and then I found some of the corresponding column. If we see that the champion is the third model related to preferential attachment model, the next one is the full graph model based, and third one is a random graph model. So the preferential attachment model is the best one in terms of all social network properties. Summary, the attributed networks, attributed networks is the closest to a social network since it has the highest total rank of main fitting features of social networks, which is seen in the table. An accumulation of several partition of Barabasi-Albert graph makes aggregated the final network closer to a social network than the original partition by Barabasi-Albert random graphs. In terms of people communications, then the two last networks simulate extreme situation where all their contacts are established randomly or they are created intentionally, respectively. But real-life communication networks most likely look like something intermediate. Thus, we propose a new model as a mixture of listed attributed networks 2 and 3 based on random graphs. These networks, we expect that it will be better because it has advantages of both these networks. For instance, diameter will become lower due to the presence of second network, and respectively average richness path will be also lower, and clustering coefficient becomes higher due to presence of the third of the last network. Thank you for your attention.